Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let's see all about change of a scale property. So this is really a simple and basic property, guys. It is nothing but if f of p is a Fourier transform of f of x, then f Fourier transform of f of a of x is equals to 1 by a f of p by a. Proof. We know that Fourier transform of f of x is equals to f of p, that is equals to integral minus infinity to infinity f of x into e power I p x dx. So in all these properties which we are proving, guys, we'll be just substituting this whole value as f of x, guys. See here, f of x is equals to f of ax. Once you substitute that, the equation will be updated in this format, right? Fourier transform of f of ax is equals to f of p is equals to integral minus infinity to infinity f of ax into e power I p x dx. So now I'll be assuming that ax is equals to a variable, guys. So let us assume that t is equals to ax. So x is equals to t by a, where dx is equals to dt by a, right? So that's absolutely perfect. So now we will be substituting these values all in this equation. So now the equation will be f of Fourier transform of f of a of x is equals to integral minus infinity to infinity f of t e to the power of I p t by a, right? Dt by a. So this a will be importing it to outside. So 1 by a f of p by a, p by a. Yeah, it's fine. Yep, that's fine. So hence proved. So I think everyone is now 100% clear with change of scale property. So now we shall also discuss about shifting property, guys. Or shall we continue it in the next tutorial? Okay, let's discuss it right now. Why to make more videos? It will be better if we discuss right now. Okay, so shifting property. If even in this situation, we will be having two cases, guys. So basically, those cases are nothing but shifting property. If f of p is a Fourier transform of f of x, then the Fourier transform of f of x minus a is equals to e to the power of I p x into f of p. And if f of a plus x, sorry, x plus a is equals to e to the power of I p a into f of p. Okay, so now let us discuss these both proofs. So now let us first discuss this minus proof. So we know that Fourier transform of f of x is equals to f of p, is equals to f of p equal to integral minus infinity to infinity f of x into e power I p x dx. So as I have told you that we'll be assuming this whole part as f of x. So f of x is equals to f of x minus a, right? So Fourier transform of f of x minus a is equals to integral minus infinity to infinity f of x minus a into e power I p x dx. So now I'll be assuming this x minus a is equals to a variable. So t is equals to x minus a, so it is indirectly equal to x is equals to t plus a. So dx equal to dt. Fine, right, it's perfect. So integral minus infinity to infinity f of t into e to the power of I p t plus a dt. Okay, so integral minus infinity to infinity f of t e power I p t into e power I p a. So in this whole part there is no t, so we can just push it out of our integral. So e to the power of I p a integral minus infinity to infinity f of t e to the power of I p t dt. So this is nothing but Fourier transform of f of t. So capital F of t. Hence proved. We have just proved the first part. So now, sorry for that. So now let us further move on to the second part. So second part we are having here plus, so it became minus here. That's it. So the process is almost same, guys. Initially we'll be writing the Fourier transform of f of x. That is nothing but integral minus infinity to infinity f of x e power I p x dx. So we'll be substituting this value in place of f of x, which is nothing but f of x equal to f of x plus a. So once we substitute that value, we'll be assuming that x plus a is something. So t is equal to x plus a. Hence x equal to t minus a. Hence dx is equals to dt, right? So here we'll be getting the minus sign. So that's the reason why we are getting e to the power of minus ipa. So here it doesn't contain any t term. So we'll be just pushing it out. So e to the power of minus ipa f of p. Hence proved. Okay guys, so now I hope everyone is now 100% clear with shifting and change of scale property. So in the next tutorial we'll be going through modulation property, guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching.